Hey guys, I am back. Welcome to Tetris for the Game Boy. And I am joined by Aries on commentary.
What up?
So yeah, we are going to try, hopefully, 800 lines starting on level 0.
Just count me in when you want to start the timer.
All right. So here we go. In 3, 2, 1, go.
All right. So hopefully people can hear me because this is not my normal mic setup. But what this is. Game Boy version of Tetris. It's a little bit different from the NES version that maybe you're used to seeing, or any other version that you're used to seeing. The randomizer in this game is actually fundamentally broken. It prefers to spit out pieces at a non-even pace. And so the goal here is that we're going to get 100 lines. This is probably the most popular version of Tetris because, you know, it hit records and Game Boy and history. Soviet Union, all that jazz. But in any case, with starting at level 0, it's going to be an obviously slower category than if you start at a higher speed, because you kind of need to wait for the blocks to fall down at whatever pace they are, instead of them dropping at a lot faster pace. But if you're newer to the game, this is probably a lot better for you, because that means you can actually control your pieces. So in any case, the goal is to get a lot of Tetrises, because of the line clear animation. What do I mean by the line clear animation? Well, whenever FFR clears a line, you'll see that the screen does that little bloop, 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 bloop. If we were to do that with single lines or singles, as I'm not going to refer to them, you'd be wasting a lot of time. So the goal is to keep doing this with Tetrises, because you're getting four lines at one line clear animation, which is how you optimize a game like this beyond just placing the pieces there. Like I said, the randomizer is a little bit annoying, so there are times where doing a Tetris isn't possible at all, but you can just keep trying. And as for every 10 lines, the level will go up, which means that the speed will increase. Now, this being a Game Boy game, this well is not as high, I believe, in comparison to other Tetris games. I do think you lose a little bit of vertical height there, but it's still very doable if you know what you're doing, and as we can see, FFR is doing a pretty bang-up job, even his right well open. And so you'll notice that actually in a lot of Tetris games, the preferred method is to keep the well on the right-hand side. In NES Tetris, people flip-flop between the two. I have a feeling you can do the same in Game Boy without any detrimental effects. But it's just preferred because in most games, the rotation system is better off with you having the hole on the right-hand side. So,
yeah,
you're able to do more.
Yeah, for NES Tetris, you do a right well because it's one less input to go to the right than to the left.
Randomly on the bottom half of the screen, and that will allow you to drop the pieces in the first half of the game a lot quicker, because you only have to drop them half the screen instead of the whole screen. You'll see that the very high level Tetris players, and at least NES Tetris, will do that for level 0 starts. In this game you could probably attempt as well, but again, it's so much harder because you just destroyed half your forgiveness of the vertical height there. But it would lead to an overall faster time. Cleared that up right there very nicely, so at this point FFR just has to keep on stacking. One of the things that is nice to pay attention for example, the move he just did there where he used the LRJ piece, I don't know which one's which, honestly, but he used it to clear off and still keep the hole open in the stack. It's something that if you're newer to Tetris, you want to keep an eye out for. You don't always have to burn a Tetris there, you can burn an LRJ piece to clear three lines out and still be useful pretty much, instead of throwing the piece somewhere else and then blocking the hole off or anything like that. There's a lot of, once you start playing the game more and more, you'll realize how pieces can connect to each other while still being in optimal placement. For example, the eye piece, it doesn't always have to fill in a Tetris. You can use it vertically flat, for example, and that will be a pretty safe bet, where you'll use it because you accidentally built up a well the other side of the screen, and a well, if I forgot to mention it, is that hole where you put the eyepiece in or any piece in to create a Tetris or a triple, double, single. But we're almost there, we're at 95 lines.
And time. Lines.
$8 will get